Hi there and welcome back to another NJS instructional video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to complete a minor service on your Ranchilio Silvia coffee machine. As part of the minor service, we'll be replacing the group head gasket as well as the group head shower screen, and we'll also be replacing the steam wand valve gasket and the two O-rings as well. So when would you want to complete a minor service like this? Well, when you start noticing that the coffee machine is maybe leaking from the group head, or that the steam wand valve is actually leaking and water is coming out of the steam wand itself. So in the first part of our video, we'll look at replacing the gasket and the shower screen for the group head. And in the second part, we'll look at replacing the valve gasket and the O-rings for the steam wand. Now, before we start, it's a good idea to disconnect the power, remove the water tank and the group handle and the trays as well. For the purposes of this video, I've turned the machine upside down just to give us better visibility around this area. Now we're going to need to undo this bolt here, and there's a few ways you can do it. One is to get a flathead screwdriver and unscrew it, or you can use an 8mm socket like what I'm going to do now. And you can see that the old shower screen is quite dirty underneath, even though on the top it actually looks quite clean. And it's very important that we don't lose this, because this is what actually distributes the water across the whole shower screen. And I'm just going to use a screwdriver to remove the old gasket. Now here's a comparison of the old gasket on the left and the new on the right. And that Ranchilio symbol, which is down here, was facing down. Now I don't think it's really important because the seals look, or the gaskets look like they're symmetrical. So overall, actually, the old gasket is in fairly good condition. It doesn't really show any signs of wear. So that's where it interacts with the group handle. So it probably could be kept as a good spare part, actually. It has started to abrade a little bit and become a bit funny on the inside. You can see just how dirty. That's not actually coffee either. So anyway, it's a good idea to replace it with the new. And before we put the new one in, we're just going to give this area a bit of a clean, make sure that our new one goes in to a nice clean place. And at the same time, it's also a good idea to give these a good clean. We won't be using this, but give these items here a good clean before we put them back in. So I've just given these items a quick wash, and you can see the color difference already. So we're going to reinstall our brass plates and then our distributor. And then over the top of that, we'll put our new shower screen. And then finally, we'll reinstall our fastener. But first, it's time to put our seal. Now the seal is pretty straightforward to install. You can just pretty much push it in with your fingers. If it is a little bit difficult, you could also use your group handle and lock it in and actually press it in by twisting the group handle. Now you don't want to over tighten the screw, just make it nice and firm. So that's how you replace the group head gasket and shower screen. Now, to replace the steam wand valve gasket and O-rings, we're actually going to have to remove the steam wand. So we'll remove the steam knob and also this cover plate and most likely the back plate as well. So here is our steam valve assembly, and we'll just have to remove this locking nut so we can slide it out of the body of the machine. But in order to do so, we'll have to loosen or remove this nut here, which is connected via copper pipe to the boiler, and we'll have to back this off a little bit just to give us a bit of movement as well. Now I'm just going to use an 18mm ring spanner to back off this nut over here. Okay. And then also do the same at the back. Now you could also remove the back section of the coffee machine just to give you a bit better access. So now we just have to remove that locking nut or loosen it so we can slide out the steam wand from the body of the coffee machine. And to do this, I'm going to use a 17mm ring spanner and just back off that nut over here. So now that the steam wand valve assembly is removed, we can remove this fastener here to get access to the gasket as well as the two O-rings. Now, in order to remove this part, you're going to need to put this brass section in a vise and then try and back this off because it's on quite tight. So now that we have removed this component, it's just a matter of screwing in this mechanism here. Until it goes all the way. So now we have our two O-rings and also our valve gasket here. And to remove that, just use pliers. Unscrew this locking fastener like that. And then we have clear access to the valve gasket. And as you can see, there's a fair bit of scoring and indentation left on this gasket. So you just simply get the new one and then put it in place like that. And then we'll get our locking screw, put it in like that. And then we replace the two O-rings. Get our new O-rings and just slide them over the top. There's one, 2 seconds. There we go. So that's all done. Our new O-rings are in place, our new valve gasket is in place. So it's time to screw this mechanism back in here. So simply just slide it through like that. And then do as much as you can by hand, screwing it in like that. That protrudes out the other side. Keep going, keep going. Go all the way. There we go. So then we go back to our vise and we'll screw this in and tighten it all up. And then it'll almost be ready to put back into the machine. So now that this has been tightened and secured on, we'll just get our spring washer here, our flat washer and our locking nut and just do it up a little bit. And careful we don't cross thread, there we go. Just push that aside. and then it's ready to reinstall into the machine. So now our steam wand and valve assembly is all back together and reconnected to the main boiler. So now that the machine is back together, we'll turn the machine on and get it up to temperature, and we'll make ourselves a coffee. We'll make sure that there's no leaks around the group head or also the steam wand area. Now, because we've put in a new rubber gasket and that's quite flexible, being brand new, you might find that the group handle comes a little bit further to the right, and that's perfectly okay as long as you get a perfect seal and there's no water leaks coming out of the group head. So let's see how we go with this coffee. So there you have it. That's how you can replace the group head gasket and shower screen, as well as a steam valve gasket and O-rings on your Ranchilio Silvia coffee machine. I hope you found this video informative. Don't forget to like it, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and hit that bell notification icon. Thanks for watching.